Alright, so this is part 2 of the Thief series. From the trials that God gave me to overcome certain particular sins in my life, okay, in my walk. Look, I'm gonna describe to you guys how I felt, you guys. I felt like such a fool, you guys. I felt like he was hell. At the same time, I felt such love and such compassion for my family. Because every day I had to go to this place, I had to drive 50 miles and wait for this guy, hoping he was going to return that day to return the car. He was always telling me, I'm coming down today. He was lying to me, you guys. He was all the way up north, you guys, and I really thought I was going to die. I thought my heart was pounding every single day. I was hyperventilating. I was breathing heavily every single day. It was bad, you guys. All because I had placed my trust on this guy. And I thought that it was okay to be renting my car. But God was telling me, I put you in this trial for a reason. So that you consider this guy. You don't call the cops on him. And you don't beat him up or whatever thing you want to do. Because I was really angry at this guy, you guys. I said, I'm going to lose my blessing from God. So God started telling me, the reason I put you in this trial is to see and to check some besetting sins in your walk. And I have your blessing. It's protected. Nobody's going to take it from you. God was telling me. So God was comforting me. But it was very difficult for me to believe, you guys. It was just difficult. I was doubting God. I was like, I'm going to call the cops right now. You guys, and God was telling me, love your neighbor as yourself. He was telling me, this is what God was telling me. God was telling me, you shouldn't call the cops on him. His bank account is frozen. You call the bank, you call the cops again. They got him. They grab him. They throw him in jail. He loses his family. And he won't be able to get out. You know, so I started feeling pity for him. But it was difficult for me to feel pity for him because I thought, this guy's going to steal my car. I was like, I'm done. You know, and I started asking God for faith. Lord, give me faith because I'm about to throw the towel. This is tough for me. This is very tough. So all of a sudden, you guys, I started hearing the voice of the devil. And the voice of the devil was telling me, you need to beat him up, or you need to kill him, or you need to call the cops on him. I don't know what you're going to do, but you need to get your car back. And he was very methodic, you guys. He was so fast. He was so methodic. He was like a voice. But at the same time, felt my own thoughts, you know. But I would stop thinking. And I would hear the voice of God telling me, be merciful to him, be compassionate, be loving. You're going to get through this. So I go to a restaurant, you guys, and I see this guy on this motorcycle. He's driving the motorcycle. He goes four times around the track, and he wins the lap. And he has a share with a number, 333. And I uploaded a video on my channel long ago, and I still have the video with me, evidence for you guys to see. I'm going to try to show you guys. And he wins the match and on his motorcycle. He wins first place. His name is Daniel. And the number of his chair is 333. So God's speaking to me. He's trying to speak to me. He says, hey, listen, you're 333, right? You're the laborer in the field. You're the one that's preaching, right? Don't make a mistake because I am your judge. Daniel means God is my judge. That's what the name Daniel means. Daniel means God is my judge. So God was telling me, I am your judge. Everything is okay. I'm with you. I have control of all things. If I put you in this trial, I'm going to pull you out. All you must do is be faithful, be firm. Don't tell anybody, I'm going to get you out of this. You don't have to call cops. But you guys, it was difficult because what I thought it was my thoughts, it was actually the voice of the devil. And he would call me so fast, like, go kill this guy. You do nothing wrong, you're defending yourself. You can get away with this. Or call the cops. You know, you have done nothing wrong. He stole from you, you know. He's stealing your money. You're going to lose what God has for you. He was very methodic. And a very reasonable voice, but it was the voice of the devil. Keep back at it twice. Don't forgive him. That was the voice of the devil, you guys. But he was very methodic. Everything he was telling me made sense to an extent. And then I will hear the voice of God telling me, have mercy, have compassion on him. I love you. I care for you. Don't make the mistake. I'm with you. I'm testing you. You're going to get out of this. You're faithful. He was telling me, you're strong. You guys, whenever I would listen to the voice of God, you guys, I would feel so much peace. He was like coming from a type of session of life into another one. When I would listen to the voice of the devil, it was coming from peace into trouble and hatred and anger. And I was getting so angry. And God was like, this is the next sin I'm dealing with you in your life, your anger and your frustration. You need to let it go. And I started praying to God, Lord, get this sin out of me, get this anger from me. Lord God, I don't want to be embittered. You guys, I was working every day with so much anger that I don't even know how I made it, because I had to work. And I had to extend the rental every day because I knew he was not going to come back. Because he stole my car, he took it to store Florida, he wasn't going to come back. He wanted to keep the car so he could use it for a few days, I guess. But I really thought he was going to steal my car. It was very difficult. Very, very difficult. So God was telling me, be strong, be firm. He's going to bring you a car. You guys, on Friday, it was 5:47. Like 3 minutes before 6. I had to extend the rental again. But so God told me, don't extend it. He's going to call you. You guys, he calls me. He's like, hey, I return your car. You guys, I felt like I was going to faint. I started sweating cold. I thought, I'm going to die now. I can't believe this. It's happened. He returned the car. That's it. It's over. I called the company. Sure enough, they have the car there. They sent me a receipt to my phone and realized, oh, the guy returned the car. That's it. The trial's over. The guy's like, listen, I need to see you to give you a blessing. That do you give or give out? I was like, dude, I don't want to know anything about you. I don't want to meet you. I don't want to talk to you. I made a mistake. I'm not going to make it again. God bless you and your family. Seek someone else's help. You guys, and I was so glad I was out of that, you guys. 5 long days, you guys. I thought I was going to die, you guys. It was horrible. It was horrible. I learned to forgive. And I learned to be less angry. Okay, but the trial is not ending yet. So I got to deal with Mr. Doubt. This was pretty tough for me. I started doubting God, and I wanted to drop. I wanted to leave. I was telling God, God, I don't want to deal with this anymore. This is tough for me. And there's a lot of drama going on, and I really don't want to deal with this anymore. So here comes coronavirus, you guys. Coronavirus hits, and I got to work every day, and it becomes tougher.